Hi guys, I'm Joa. Thank you for watching this video. So I got a second copy of Oracle Chair from my alliance member, 5BSRJ. He or she, thank you. And so just very excited, and immediately I'm going to max her out, change her into Celestial Oracle, right? Or I forgot the name of the card, but you know what I mean. And so here, so before you evolve anything, if you plan to use her, remember to max out a level. Okay, so I have to be very careful. And you have to use Arcana. This is the Arcana you should use, Arcana Succession. By now it should be second nature. You should be extremely familiar. But sometimes, even players like me forget to use it because we're not paying attention or anything. Okay, so I got that, and then I'm gonna evolve, max level, use Arcana and evolve, and you don't have to use the other Arcana yet, because the other Arcana isn't as useful when you're not at the level of the highest level like G you are or H you are, and I can't find that card anymore. Okay, here she is, and obviously I'm going to, this is new for me, what is going on? Okay, so that's not what I need. Okay, so I need GUR Oracle Chair. So this is it, so I need to awaken her, and I can only awaken her two times. Let me try two times. Wow, 30%? Are you kidding me? Okay, let's see if I can do this. Okay, so I've gotten my amazing amount of stones, and then here I'm going to try to awaken my Oracle Chair to Celestial Oracle. Let's see if I can do it. I have 5 tries. And it's looking tough. Let's see, I can do it. They really need to fix this bug where after awakening you cannot immediately drop the card back into the awaken try. Oh, still no, unbelievable. It's 4 times already, along with the 2 tries, which I will add it into this video. Or more like I'll add these tries into. Okay, I feel it. It's coming. Yes! GUR Oracle Chair. And so here we are. Oh! Alright. Okay, and you can see here already she has 2 skills. Auto skill unit attack plus 50%, and Valkyrie Glasses. Unleash a single ally skill at 20%. And then we are going to move on. So here I'm going to amalgamate her into GUR. GUR. Okay, you know what? I'm gonna go. You know what? I'm gonna go extra safe plus cheese over here. I am going to feed her slimes to max out her level first before I amalgamate her. Probably it represents a waste of slimes, but you know, I don't want to take any chances. Is that enough? Is that enough? Okay, keep going. Probably 2 more isn't enough actually. Let's do it. I've got lots of slimes, I don't really care. Oh, wow. Ouch. So many slimes. What's going on? Hi guys, so it's me back again, and I'm going to try to max out my Oracle Chair. I am taking no chances, so before I used 2 slimes and it gave me 300%, so So I'm gonna use 3 slimes and probably I'll get maxed out GUR Oracle Chair. God damn it! Why? This is getting ridiculous, I'm telling you. But I have infinite amounts of metal, so I don't really care. And so here I am, a maxed out level GUR, which I'm going to combine with. Which I'm going to combine with my red cape, Laurel. And maybe you'll ask, is it necessary to max out your GUR before you amalgamate the red cape with her? To be honest, I don't really know. And I'm not taking any chances. And I don't feel like looking up Wikipedia. So I'm gonna do it this way. Okay, here we go. Arcana, we can confirm that there is no need for Arcana, although now that I think about it, maybe I won't use it, so you can just see what it's like. Okay, this is very, so amalgamation, no need Arcana, max level, both of them. Okay, let's go. So a funny story is that one of my alliance members actually accidentally evolved his or her celestial oracle with the Laurel, as in ate the Laurel. Yep, that was a tragedy for him or her, comedy for the rest of us. I'm sorry, it was quite shocking. I don't think it was a Lions member, it was a YouTube viewer. Yes. Yes, so. There you go. Second skill, unit attack plus 100%. Extremely excited. And I'm gonna feed her slimes, as usual. Okay, so I released my slime, so I'm about to feed her. But before I feed her, I have to talk about her attack and defense. Look, the attack and defense, the number of soldiers. From what I can see here, I feel like it's because I maxed her out. 17017 is a very arbitrary number. Also attack and defense as well. Maybe someone can confirm it, or maybe I'll look up Wikipedia later, but I can't be arsed to look it up now, and so that's it. Okay, so I'll feed her some slimes and then I'll talk about her skill. Second skill really makes her extremely useful because it removes the need to buff up your main attacker too many times. In higher level teams, the whole team is your attacker because you have a super buffer, a buffer that buffs your defense and your attack. And then having this GUR card, Celestial Oracle, would have additional, you can see a second skill, unit attack plus 100%, which doubles your attack basically. And if you have two copies of her, it would pretty much negate the need to have to buff up your cards four times, right? Because the normal thing is to buff up your cards four times, and then it will have the max amount of attack when they are in the awakened state. That means over 35 million. Yes? Or is it 3.5 million? Over 3.5 million, I think. Yes, 35 million is a bit much, unfortunately. Okay, so that's it. So I'm going to put her in my team. And that's it for my video. Thank you very much. And good luck, everybody. Good luck.